Welcome to LawnCrack, and this is the 5,000 subscriber episode. I cannot believe we reached 5,000 subs. That is absolutely insane. Thank you so much. But I wanted to give you a quick tour of my place and then show you the giveaways that we have going on as we are going through the countdown to GIE. And I was also just going to run through kind of some of the equipment we're using to make these videos for you. And yeah, that's basically the gist of it. So this is where I moved. It is called Aqua on the Levee, and I love this place compared to where I came from, which was a house in Ellesmere. So I just moved about 10, 15 miles north, and it is a complete world of difference up here than down there, and I absolutely love it. But with the help of my girlfriend and my parents and my brother, we got this place whipped into shape. I still do have some of the crap that I'm trying to sell from my old house, but for the most part, we've got rid of most of that stuff and we're looking pretty good. So if you come on in, we have the nice little decoration wall right here, which I think turned out great. And most of this stuff came from charity auctions. I like to support those whenever possible. Got that in Jamaica, so that's really cool, special to me. But the other stuff was just charity stuff, and then got that at Big Lots. You know, the $12 clock's looking really good right there. But as we come on through here, this is the whole kitchen island area, and I like this stuff. I mean, this is just so much nicer than the stuff that I had at my house. It's about the same quality as the stuff I put in right as I left my house, but I never got to use the new appliances there. But the like glass tile backsplash, I really like that. You know what I'm saying? For how like small the apartment is, there's really a lot of storage and all that kind of stuff. So it's not that bad. And I really wanted to clear out, like, we just have this stuff here for the video. Normally this is cleared and empty. And I literally do keep the house, keep the apartment almost this clean. Like, it's a little slightly dirtier, but we just cleaned for 3 to 5 minutes before the video, got it back to this, got this stuff out. I hate having clutter and all that kind of stuff messing me up throughout my day, but we got the little couch and everything so you can watch the TV. I keep this here because this is just a big stuffed animal I got for my daughter. So I leave that there. So I see that every time I walk in the door. So I think of her. And this was a custom bar top I made. So this was actually like on a bar on an island in my old kitchen, but I did not want to get rid of it as it took me a long time to drink all that beer. And literally I did not like get any of these beer caps from anywhere. It was years of drinking six packs of craft beer, and that is that. There's a handful of Bud Light, Miller Light, Budweiser, that kind of regular stuff in there. But for the most part, it's Belgian beers, craft beers, Japanese beers, all that kind of stuff. Really good stuff. So that's really cool. But started recycling when I got here. So got the trash can, got the recycle can, and then I had to get this mirror. Can you try to get like some kind of an angle where you can see? So the whole purpose of this mirror spanning this wall was I had that custom made when I got here, because this is where I sit all day long as I bust stuff out on the computer, and I get this view of the Great American Building right there, and I freaking love it. So that is why the mirror went there. It was 100% worth it, and it was pretty funny. Me and Amy were gonna install that ourselves until we were just trying to get it like from the glass place to here. Like, okay, how much for you guys to do this? So that was that, but this is the setup where I'm getting all my stuff done. I am gonna go ahead and just get like a supercomputer because I spend so much time on the computer. If it's spinning, I'm waiting for the computer to think I'm like losing money and losing my mind at the same time. But this is the mic that I use when I record the screen videos. It's the Blue Snowball. I really like this thing. It was like 50 bucks. The sound quality is great. And while I'm thinking of it, let's not miss the wheel on the ceiling, because I love that thing. And I did not know what to do with it. I got it at a bike or car show. at the Duke Energy Center in downtown Cincinnati years ago. And I was just like, I don't know what I'm going to do with this thing. And I found it when I was moving in the garage. It was just in a box. I was like, holy crap. I was like, that would be like really cool hanging from the ceiling. So stuck it up there. And then this globe, I absolutely love this globe. Amy got this for me in Vegas. And it's great. It's awesome. It's really cool. It's like some kind of marbly material it's made out of. And this place is going out of business, so we got a hell of a deal on this globe. But we got the laptop, because you can't just have a computer anymore. You got to have a laptop. I also got an iPad, but I cannot stand really Apple products in general. I don't know why. I've never given the iPhone a chance, but the iPad was such a bad experience to me that I was like, I don't need to. Screw it. Here's the TV that I really don't even use. Basically just watch YouTube videos on it. I have not hooked up the cable or anything. I don't care. I don't have time for TV. I just keep the tripod here. And this is also very special to me. This was my grandfather's, and it just has all these cool things. I don't even know what these are, but he spent a lot of time in Europe. He was a big wig at the Continental Can Company, and this is one of his decorative canes that ended up with me, so I will keep this forever.
And are those, are they family crests?
No, I don't know what they are. But, well, maybe they are, not our family or anything, but my mom, like, really felt I needed a rug, so we have a rug here, and it's yellow, so it gets, like, dirt on it, and it shows, and it drives me crazy, but what can you do? And we'll step out real quick, check out the balcony. We have the pool view. We have downtown Cincinnati. There's the Red Stadium. This is the Purple People Bridge. And this is a little area. I have not got around to getting patio furniture, but it's just so tight. It's like, if you put patio furniture here, you'd like almost have no room to walk. And then this bike's a kind of funny story. I got this from an auction site for like 22, 23 bucks. To find out it's missing a seat, it's missing the pedals. You know, it's not functional as it is, so I gotta do some work to get this bike working, and maybe one day I'll get around to that. But let's go back inside. I'll quickly show you the bedroom, the bathroom, so you get the whole complete tour, and I guess the laundry room too. Okay, so here's the bedroom. I started making my bed like a month or two ago, and honestly, I would highly recommend start making your bed in the morning. It's crazy. I watched one of those motivational videos. I can't remember what channel it was on, but it's one of those ones on YouTube that they post out the videos, and it was some Navy SEAL, and he said he starts off his day every day by making his bed because that's just like an accomplishment, and it starts building momentum for the rest of the day. And I was like, makes sense to me. I'll adopt that, and started rolling with it, and it's been great. So every time I walk by, I see my bed's made, and it just looks, makes me feel so much better than if it was in disarray, like when I got out of bed. I do like this ceiling fan. It's not like a typical like wood regular one, so I think that's pretty modern and sleek. If you didn't get enough of the skyline, we went ahead and just threw the skyline on the wall again. And then here is like an example of some of the stuff that we still need to get rid of from my house. So got some subs and some other junk right there. And then if you pop in here, we have the walk-in closet where I have all my stuff, and I offloaded probably two times that much clothes and shoes, and I still have all my shoes. Check these bad boys out. You know, when you're from Kentucky, you have to have a pair of cowboy boots. I'm just kidding. I would not have got these. I got these as being a bachelor guy, bachelor man.
A groomsman.
So, other groomsman.
A bachelor guy.
Oh my gosh. Okay. So, these things are Stetsons. These things are freaking nice. And I actually really do like these, but they just don't go with my style at all. So, it's very hard for me to ever wear them. But I do wear them occasionally, and I really like them. But, you know, there's a handful of shoes. They're worth so much more. This is actually what's left of my baseball card collection right here. So I was really big into collecting baseball cards. And then here's the couple remaining pro slides we have left. There is one more left out there. And this may become something or may not.
but this was handmade by a local vet, and I am hoping to partner with this guy and start selling these things online, because I just think it's freaking awesome personally. So please let me know what you think about this thing in the comments, but to me, that is super slick. I really, really like that. And then all that's left really, well, we have the bathroom, we have a couple closets,
and that's about it. But here's the bathroom, you got the his and her sink. I have this see no evil, hear no evil, speak no evil, and I bought those from the guy who made them by hand in Jamaica. So that was really cool. Shower, glass door, I mean, it's just, basically it's a shower, so whatever. Come on through. So then you loop back to the front. So here's the front door.
Some pictures of me, my daughter, and her sister Mariah. And a little closet for hoodies, jackets, whatever. I got some more random stuff stuffed in there. And that's that. And then really, the last thing we got, I guess we have two more things, but the laundry room. Really do like actually having my washer and dryer. And there's the rest of the stuff that has not made it out of, that was at, in my house, that has not made it out. And then, you know what I'm saying, the overflow stuff that can't fit in the fridge yet is in there, stuff like that. But hopefully we'll get all this stuff sold so I can actually do my laundry from like in my laundry room instead of reaching over and doing it like that. But whatever, it's not that big of a deal. And then the last thing is right here, but it's really nothing. It's the water heater and the HVAC for the apartment, stuff like that. So nothing to see there. Some boxes as I ship stuff. So boxes are there when I need the boxes.
Okay, and now we are on to the island stuff. So we will get back to this last, but if anybody has a guess what this could be, please let me know, because I think it's hilarious and ironic what it is. But before we get to the colorful stuff on the island, I wanted to show you some of the stuff we are using. So we have not made too many drone videos, but here is the DJI Mavic Pro drone that we are shooting with. And we shot some footage today. We'll get some more and start putting out some videos of people in the field and stuff like that. Some of my old guys, some of the other local companies. So here's this, the carrying case that houses all this stuff for when we travel with the drone. The camera, the nice camera we're using, is a Sony 6300A or A6300. So it's a mirrorless camera, I believe. So, you know, latest technology. You know, I think this is like 9 months old, so I'm sure it's been surpassed already. But what can you do? Technology just advances so fast. So this is what holds the GoPro onto my windshield in my car. And then we have the GoPro Hero Session 5 is what we are shooting with there. I really like this thing, except it has the SD card error that happens a lot, which is really frustrating when you go to shoot and you can't, because it just says SD card error. And that's really frustrating because there's nothing you can do except for pop the SD card back in the computer to reset it. So that's really frustrating. So we'll do this second last. We'll take a look at this. So this is a Zomax chainsaw. So I found this at the GIE show in 2017. I paid cash for it at the show. I'll be making a video pretty soon on buying stuff at the show. So $80, I bought this chainsaw. This is comparable to a $200 or $300 steel chainsaw. And Zomax is actually a very popular brand in other parts of the world. They outsell steel in some parts of the world, such as Brazil and some Asian markets. So it's 100% legit brand. You know, how easy is it gonna be to get parts in the US? I don't know, but I'll be giving this away. It is unused, it's a little dirty. I'll clean it up before I ship it to you. And with winter quickly approaching, here are some steaks that we just never used. They're still in the same packaging they got shipped to us in. So I'll be giving these away on an upcoming video. And as we are going through the whole countdown to GIE, we have these line cutters, which I have a ton of these bad boys, and we'll be giving these away. And we branded them with Optimized and LawnCrack.
So what we're going to be doing here is we'll have a contest every week. I think we're going to be shipping two. We'll ship you a yellow one and a red one for free. And, you know, we'll just give it to people who leave comments on the videos for that week. And we'll do it like that. So if you want to win in the contest, a great way to do it is, for one, you have to be subbed to the YouTube channel. And you need to leave a comment. Some of the stuff will be going off on Facebook. So, and maybe even Instagram. So if you want a chance to win all of this stuff, you're going to need to be following LawnCrack on, you know, YouTube, Facebook, Instagram. So that's where we are. And of course, we're on LawnCrack.com. But that's that. If you guys haven't used these, you stick your string in there. You just kind of create a little thing with it. Pop it in there. It cuts it. There's no, with a pocket knife or something, there's a really good chance you'll cut yourself. I've cut myself several times. No chance you're going to cut yourself with these things. They last forever. They're super cheap. They're for sale on LawnCrack.com if you want to buy them, but we're giving them away, so all you got to do is comment. You can just win one. So, we have a pro slide. So this is what I'm giving away for the 5,000 sub mark. So it is, we're going to call it a demo unit. It looks brand freaking new. So somebody bought this one. They did not like it. They had never used it before. It was a personal preference that they did not like the Pro Slide over the wheel Velky. So they wanted to send it back. I said, fine, paid for the shipping, everything. They were out a dollar. I've already lost a ton of money on this. So I'm like, why not give it away at this point? You know what I mean? So this is being given away. We're gonna give this away next Friday. So that's gonna be, I have no idea what the date's gonna be. But
September 2nd, I think.
It's not gonna be September 2nd. But whatever, we'll put it on the screen.
Okay.
So I'll go there, and then we'll get to this bad boy.
How do you win the Pro Slide?
Okay. Shit. Okay. So to win the Pro Slide XT. We'll be giving this away a week from today. Can you look on your phone or something? Like, what is it? Okay, so to win the Pro Slide, you need to have been subbed to LawnCrack by August 31st, 2018. So if you are a sub of the LawnCrack channel, then you are eligible to win the Pro Slide. On August 31st, it's next Friday, we're giving it away. So what we're gonna do is we'll do a screen record video and we'll run it through a random generator where it'll take everyone who is subbed to the channel and then it'll just randomly pick somebody. So then I'll announce the winner. Then you'll have, I'll give you maybe a week to get, you know, if you don't see the video, maybe someone will let you know and you just contact me and I will ship you the Pro Slide. If you don't want the Pro Slide, let me know. Maybe we can work something out. But that is what it is. So if you just really don't want it, maybe you can just say, hey, do another drawing and somebody that wants it can get it. Cause I'd really, really like somebody that like could really use one, but just really can't afford one to get it. Like that's kind of the whole point of giving stuff away. But this is the hilarious thing to me, because if you did not know, the most popular video on the LawnCrack channel is the video on blade sharpening. And I have gotten so much crap in the comments of that video because I don't sharpen blades. I never sharpen blades. Guess what? The company that taught me everything, they had been in business for, I believe, 18 years before I started working for them, never sharpened a blade. They've never had an issue with a bearing, a spindle, nothing. I haven't either. I didn't ever do it on my mowers. Probably put 10,000 plus hours on a mower by myself. Never had an issue with the blades being out of balance and burning up a bearing or a spindle or anything like that. So if you want to balance your blades, knock yourself out. But I don't feel you have to, but if you really want to, guess what? LawnCrack has you covered with a brand new, never used, official X-Mark OEM blade balancer. So you will have to figure out how to use this thing, because I'm not going to be the person to tell you, because I really don't know. But if you do want it, hopefully you do know how to use it. But
This goes in here. I know this goes in here, and this is your checker to make sure your blade's not bent. These right here, going around here, are magnets. That's gonna hold your blade on the cone right there. Mount this to your wall with the holes, and then your blade will balance, and you'll know which side is heavy, which side to take more off of. But as far as me ever using one of these, I don't know, so I can't really give you any tips there. But that is that, and we'll be giving all this stuff away. All you have to do is stay tuned and learn when we're giving what away. But basically, we will be pumping out more videos as we do the countdown to GIE in 2018. Super excited about it. Lots of people I want to meet down there. And just once again, thank you so much for watching the channel, subscribing, liking, every comment, good or bad. I really like them. And I just really, really appreciate it. Thank you so much. If we can help in any way, just let us know. If you have topics for videos, I could definitely use different video topics. So please feel free to leave them in the comments. So really, that's about it for this video. I wanted to show you around the place. We will be showing you around the whole building because there's lots of like features and amenities that you get living here that I thought was pretty cool that kind of pushed me over the edge because the space in the apartment is a little small, but I just don't need a lot of space. I don't know what I need all this extra space for. It's just like more stuff to keep clean. So screw it, I don't have it. I don't need to worry about it. Yeah, man. Thanks so much for the 5,000 sub mark. Really appreciate you watching. Until the next video, keep making money.